Well, it's going to be a very, very, very creepy night. I have a sneaking suspicion as we bring in the great Jambo Comics and Captain Strangelife. That intro was so scary, most of you guys had to stay outside and wait until it was all over. And we have a good night planned for you. Who's in the chat? Recess says, I can't wait. Been looking forward to this. So have I. Maranya, I guess she's got her usual complaint for some reason. And here's someone that acknowledges Eric's existence, Todd True. We hear good things about Todd. Michael Taylor's here. And Lead Paint, good to see you.
Lead Paint.
And Maranya, good evening. Yes, good evening, Maranya. Well, we all hope your wishes and dreams come true. Creepy for sure. Jackson, Roy Kirk, and we welcome Easy Comic Creator. Great stuff. All right.
How's everybody doing?
I think we're doing pretty good.
Good. Great. Better good than that good.
I may need to turn on another light bulb. It's kind of dark here, but we will go to Steve right away. So, Steve.
All right.
We are going to you.
Cool. All right.
At least I thought I did.
Okay.
There it is.
All right, great. Not really a Twilight Zone. Hope everyone's doing well, by the way. Sorry about that. Thanks for being here. Hello, everyone. Not really a Twilight Zone, but I got my Plan 9 in my reading box. Found it from outer space. I think I showed it before, but this is a hodgepodge of stuff that I got in my reading box for this week. This was in there.
That's cool.
And the Real Pulp Comics number 1 from the Mint Print Mint. This is the first appearance of Zippy the Pinhead, which is one of my favorite comic strips. Hard to understand. Don't understand them all, but I love Zippy, and this is the first appearance.
As long as it's entertaining.
Yeah, exactly. And this is an early appearance of Zippy. This is also from Print Mint, Tails and Toad, early Zippy.
Tales
number 2, Tales of the Toad. Number 3. And these are some oddball stuff I dug out. Flaming Carrot Comics 1.
Who put that out? Tales of the Toad.
That was Print Mint.
That's the company?
Yeah, it's called Print Mint.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. With Zippy's Hoppy Toadettes at the top. Yeah, I've got to have some Zippy in my life, man. This is not the same without some Zippy. Got some Flaming Carrot, this first issue. And Flaming Carrot number 2. Such great. I mean, quirky. I mean, if you like it, you like it. If you don't, you don't.
I have a few of those myself.
Yeah. It's a fun comic. I'm trying to find his first appearance in Visions. Tough fanzine to find. I know Rod showed this last week. This is my copy. It happened to be in the reading pile.
Nice.
Flash of the 137. Vandal Savage is one of
I like that cover. That's a good cover.
Yeah, it's a classic Silver Age.
Yeah. Vandal Savage, one of my favorites, along with Decaton and Darkseid. This is 235. Vandal Savage rocking it to all three heroes. Everyone's down for the count. This is 235. And a little Golden Age, action here. Captain Arrow number 22, LB Cole cover.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. I like it. It's one of my only Captain Arrow. I got one more. I have one more. It's not in the pile. I know Meyer mentioned Skyman. This is my only Skyman comic, number 3.
I've got that one. Yeah, that's a good one.
Nice. Yeah, it's a great cover.
It's my favorite cover of Skyman. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Beautiful cover.
Barrel art, for sure.
Yeah. I just love his bigger drawing. He's just such a great artist, man. Ogden Whitney.
Yes, he is.
Yeah, Ogden Whitney's phenomenal. This is 2000 Space Odyssey with Machine Man or Mr. Machine.
Is that number 8?
Yeah.
That's the first appearance then.
Yeah. Yeah. I got my other issues. He was just pulled out. I think, I don't know why this was separated from the rest of my Machine Man run. Showcase 97.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
Forrest Franklin War Stories 138. My parents of enemies.
Enemies.
Phenomenal cover on this one. Here's 139. Forrest Franklin War Stories. Madam Xanadu, number 1. The collector's only edition because it says so at the top. So don't be fooled. And last one I'm going to show for this run, Unusual Tales. I do not know what number this is. It's not on the book. But anyway, Comics Code issue, but still pretty cool.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
I have that I got that cover. I don't know what issue it is, but I have the same.
I didn't write it on the back. I rebagged and bored these a while back and I didn't write it like I should have. So thanks, guys. I appreciate it.
Okay. Yeah. Very, very, very good. Apollo has sent over some files for us, so let's take a quick look.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, look there.
Alpha. Yeah. All right. Mm-hmm. Comics published in Brazil in 1988, 35 years ago. Elf was published. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Elf lasted for about a year and a half in Brazil. This is issue number 1. So it didn't get to the famous seal cover. It was canceled. <for that. laughs> Globo at the time they published Monica's Gang, so they were outselling Disney in the kids comics department, so they thought they'd get the rights to Elf. Editora Abril was not interested, and 1.5 years for Globe was not bad, but it's not exactly a resounding success either. Grotu and Graphic Man were talking about Magic of the Spell in a live stream a couple of weeks ago. So in 1988, they published both this almanac featuring only stories from Mad Madam Min, who in the favorite stories that they published in Brazil were the ones when she was trying to.
Whoa!
What the hell?
Trying to marry the Phantom Blot. And here she is, Magic of the Spell.
That's Mega, make America great again.
That's they call her Maga Patalógica in Brazil.
Thanks, Michael.
Is that a cover designed for in Portugal, or is that ever printed in the United States?
This is for, I'm not sure, although it's very likely that it was published produced by the Brazilian publisher. They had a team of guys who worked on the kids comics, not especially Disney. There are a bunch of guys who are famous in Brazil for having created Brazil specific Disney stories, and of course they would produce the covers. If it was something that they, because a lot of the Disney comics in Brazil were themed, so they had to do a cover specifically for that theme, and it might not be available in the US or Italy.
I'm wondering if that picture you have there has enough resolution it could be made into a poster.
Make America great again, yeah.
I didn't even catch that. Oh,
yeah. You're right. Mega, make America great again.
That should be his next poster.
Yes.
Bravestar, nowadays. Cool. Yeah. Here's the thing. Bravestar was never very famous. It didn't last very long, the toy property. I used to watch the cartoon. It wasn't as interesting as Thundercats or even as the Silverhawks, but I did watch it. So there are very few Bravestar comics in the US. This issue number one feature stories made in Italy, but the title continued for about a year. And most of those stories are produced in Brazil by the same guys who did the Disney comics. So here you can see a Brazilian cover. It's an art style that you've also seen some of the Brazilian Thundercats covers. That's and nice. This one is by Mark Campos, who was one of the first Brazilians to work in the U.S. market. Of course, he was not as good as Mike Diodato, so he was never as famous. Even in 1988, the Capitão Mistério brand was still putting out these Tomb of Dracula inspired magazines. Although at this stage they were mostly selling to old fans who still remember the old horror comics. So all of these stories are made in Brazil. This is issue number 11 from this title. So they kept coming up with new numbering.
Hmm.
Another one. This is issue number 12.
Wow, look at that cover.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, this one I liked. Chiclete com Banana, one of the best humor magazines made in Brazil. Very risque. This is issue number 14. This is Mara Tara. She's a dominatrix. Although not a lot of people. She's not very good at being a dominatrix, but she does get guys interested in her. This is issue number 15, the Scrotinhos, basically the ball sacks. That's what their name translates to. They have very political. They had even in the 80s, their humor was very politically incorrect. But I have a few of their stories in Portuguese reprints. Cine Disney, one of those themed magazines that Editora Abril liked to do. So here, there's an adaptation of James Bond starring Goofy. Yeah, they did a couple of these. They ended up doing a straight up adaptation, so they weren't this fun. Newsstand comic that reprinted a Brazilian a French graphic novel. So this is The Bird of Time by Loisel, so very famous at the time. Loisel has a lot of fans in Portugal, but in Brazil it was kind of hard to get the audience interested in the European comics, because these usually ended up being a lot more expensive and not everybody could afford them, even in a format that was made for the newsstand. Daredevil Special. So the Frank Miller stories had been published. Yeah. The Frank Miller stories had been published about 4 years, five and 6 years before this. Yeah, nice, nice range of slide. And They appeared in an anthology called Super Aventuras. Here they decided to reprint all of the Frank Miller material in its proper order. So this one is a 130-page special, digest-sized. This one actually has a spine. And one thing that, about Frank Miller, he was one of two people who you could put his name on the cover and the comic would sell because of it. The other one was John Byrne. And I think they put out three specials with Daredevil. DuckTales, a rare case of the Disney comic made in Brazil, where the theme is actually centered around the creator. Although they have DuckTales artwork and characters, these reprint the original Carl Barks stories that were the inspiration for the DuckTales cartoon. This is issue number 2, and this is number 3. So you see there's Launchpad there, but these stories are inside of, they're made by Carl Barks, so they don't actually have Launchpad. And here's Magica again. He-Man, number 25. He-Man lasted a lot longer in Brazil than it ever did with any publisher in the United States. These stories were made in Brazil. But they had a pretty good cover artist. This one has a U.S. cover. This is a Ron Wilson cover. But this one's Brazilian. This is number 30. And this is number 32. This one is signed by the Brazilian artist Moacir Rodrigues, who had a lot of Disney stories made by him. And still it kept going beyond this. The Immortals by Enki Bilal, another one that was reformatted for newsstand publication. In Portugal, we had this in a proper album, even though it was soft cover. Enki Bilal was born in Yugoslavia, but his parents immigrated to France, and so he grew up there, and he's part of the French comics scene. He must be in his 70s by now. 70s, maybe. No, I think he's in his 80s by now. But he's still making new comics, and I have a couple of them that came out this decade. Brazilian Mad Magazine. Yeah. Most of the Mad Magazine material came from the U.S., but there were a couple of strips that were made in Brazil, and as well as the editorials were written by the Brazilian editor at the time. Something that's very rare. I was looking at stuff and I didn't even know this existed. This never came to Portugal, so you can only find it in Brazil. One shot Mystery 3D. The publisher is unknown to me. I don't even know who these guys are, if they did a lot of comics or not. Nickel Nausea, another one of those Brazilian humor magazines. The character is the name refers to one of the main characters, which is this mouse. He would eventually graduate to become a proper newspaper strip. So he became mainstream. Brazilian edition of Ronin. This is what they call the deluxe format, which means US size. It might be, I don't actually know.
I think a lot when that first came out, a lot of people speculated on that, and now I don't think it's hardly worth anything here in the States, that issue.
Yeah, besides it keeps getting reprinted. So if the type of people that would want to own Ronin want to read it, and they can just buy the trade paperback collection. It's issue number 2. and issue number 4. Actually, I picked this cover so just so then I wouldn't show everything. She-Ra gonna get some number 1 as a spin-off of He-Man.
All right.
A lot of the stories also made in Brazil. And the adaptation of Who Framed Roger Rabbit coming out as a US-sized, what they call the graphic novel line, although it's not part of the graphic novel title.
Bondage cover.
Yeah, it is. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because Roger Rabbit, it was a success in the entire world. And for a lot of people, the opportunity to see Disney and Warner Brothers characters together in the same movie and the merging of animation and real life, yeah, a lot of people wanted to see this. And yeah, I think we're done here. So yeah, these were all 1988, and a lot of this stuff I really wasn't interested in buying because they had kiddie stories, and by the time even when these came out in Portugal, I thought, I'm 9 years old. I don't buy this type of stuff.
Paolo, can you send me that file over from Mega? The comic book
from Manga, yeah.
I'll contact you on Instagram.
Yeah, sure. Not a problem. I'll see if I can actually get it from Index, because in the Brazilian website they put their seal on the images, so they don't get stolen. But but I'll see if they have it on Index, because it'll be clean.
Yeah, I'd like to make a poster out of it, mm-hmm. Like Gratu was saying.
Okay.
They will make a great poster.
Mm-hmm. So I got to go to bed now, and I'll watch the rest later when I wake up.
All right.
Okay. Take care. Hi, Paulo.
Hey, guys. Good night. Paulo.
Take care, buddy.
Hi, Paulo.
Take care.
Steve, you've been having some computer troubles.
Oh, yeah. I know. I wouldn't reset the internet. Hopefully, everything's fine. My wife wasn't on or anything. It wasn't that. So
it's like me last week.
Yeah, I don't know. I never had problems.
Got a brand new hamster this week, guys. So I'm hoping it's going to do better for me.
Well, speaking of Jambo, let's go to Jambo, and then I'll go.
All right. I got some cool stuff from Kevin from Gotham City Comics this week. That.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Very, very cool.
That's one of those PS art books, but it was still really cool. I mean, it had all the covers and all the ads and stuff inside of it. Nice. So, yeah, I started reading some of those. They were a lot of fun.
I think I'm going to be picking that up, too.
I see. Yeah. Really cool, Kevin. I would get it. Yeah. I was going to get Paulo to tell me. I think it's Mexican, I believe. It's a Mexican hop along.
Excellent.
He's very cool.
He's protecting the border.
So,
yeah. Too bad he's not around.
And yeah, I thought if I could figure out a way just to put this up there as my face picture.
Hello, Gabby.
Kind of looks like you, yeah.
I know it. Put my hat on. That'd be cool.
Very cool.
I said something about that in my video, and Jackson said Gabby was too young to be a fossil, so.
Yeah.
He's a Weisenheimer, that Jackson, I tell you.
These are so
Weisenheimer.
Only a fossil would use that term.
Yeah.
I know, right? Very cool.
Where do I get that? Like that?
Yeah. Garbage can, maybe. I don't know. These are great. I guess you guys probably, most of you guys probably have all these, right? I mean, they're so cool.
Oh yeah, to have those.
Very cool. Yeah.
I've had them at one time, and I don't know, probably gotten away from me. I've gave them to somebody, let them read them, and never got them back. You know, it's just good to go back and read them.
Yeah, that's my first introduction to the Silver Age, those stories, you know?
Yeah. Well, because you got such a variety of it. Yeah,
great stuff, man.
Yep. Yeah, I had a nice Kit Carson with a
pencil
cover. Yeah. The Indian getting ready to sneak attack him there.
What's he sitting in? Or
I think he's on top of a roof of something there.
Oh, like a mission or something like that.
Yeah. The Alamo. Like a
Mexican mission.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, that was pretty cool. That was from, well, I didn't write it down. The Golden Age.
Oh, there you go. I need that issue. I'm missing that one.
Yeah, I don't have many of these later issues.
$25 for that.
What?
Crazy. Yeah.
It is crazy. Why?
It was mint. I mean, beautiful. But $25.
Yeah, that's ridiculous.
Must have been at the movie hype or something.
I guess.
Yeah, it was about a month ago.
This is number 124. Look at that ghost. Yeah. Look at his head up there. What's up with that? Come on. Got
a mouthful of Brill Cream.
Yeah.
Slick back.
Little look at the bone gold. Characters. The bone
didn't gold. They model Captain Marvel after Fred McMurray?
Yes.
Yep. You always had all the
that's what Ross does. That's his.
He had all the Brill Cream in his hair, so yeah, he's gonna get a tongue full of Brill Cream.
Yeah.
I wonder if that's still around. That Brill Cream I used to use.
Not sure. One more.
If there's Aqua Velva still around, there's Brill Cream. That's a nice cover.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll show one more. I got a nice vampy.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the creature looks like Cthulhu back there in the background.
Yeah,
it does.
It is.
It's number 105. The later ones are kind of hard to find, and the early ones are expensive. So, yeah. Oh, that's it for this round.
Okay. All right, very good stuff, Gambo.
Thanks, sir.
And I guess I will go. And I will start off by showing a little Twilight Zone.
All right.
It's got a little poor Rod's face. Has been hurt, but I'll take them.
Oh, man.
I'll take them all day long. I think this guy worked for Gulf Western or Shell oil company. And not exactly Twilight Zone, but here's some Forbidden Worlds.
Oh, yeah. They had a lot of green ghosts, didn't they?
Yes.
Yeah, they seemed to do that a lot.
Here's one that was just transparent. But the tree is more probably threatening. This could have been Weird War Tales. And when you're dealing with Twilight Zone, things are kind of crazy. So we got Madhouse Mad. And this poor protester, he has run out of things to protest.
Wow.
These days I could
look at those clothes. Yeah.
I could tell a bunch of things to protest.
Yeah. The color palette was something back then. Jeez.
And
hippie shouldn't have been taking that dope. He would have remembered what he was protesting.
This is as close as Pep will get to a romance comic because everybody's kind of budding up, and then in the background there's Moose and Midge.
Except for old Jughead, he's not worried about it, is he?
No, he's asexual, you know. Jughead is asexual.
He is now, and I'm sure.
And kind of scary tonight.
All right.
I hope this title isn't ominous of things to come. and the Moon Knight shows up.
Uh-oh. There you go. That's cool.
Marvel's Batman.
Action Comics? Yes.
Wow.
Wow, that's a cool one. I've seen that one. That's neat.
I'd like to know the official count of how many times his identity has been officially exposed. Mm-hmm. So Captain America.
Oh, there you go. I love that cover. Yeah, that's a good one.
The Daredevil.
Wow.
And there's always good Charlton action.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Was monster funny. Love it.
Wish I could shake this feeling. And here's Iron Man.
Yeah. Bob Layton, baby.
I thought this was Romita Jr.
Yeah, you know what? Is Layton inked? If it's not Romita Jr., Layton inked it, so it's heavy on his work. But you're all right. Okay. You're absolutely right. He did the layouts and breakdowns, and Layton finished it out. But being a Layton fan, I always got to call it out.
It's kind of odd. I don't recall putting this in the stack, but that's
I can think of a good reason why you put that.
Yeah.
No matter how far you go back in time, the noses are still the same.
And this one,
nice.
You know.
Yeah. Coming right at you, Mike. Look at that.
Yeah.
Kane in 3D.
I don't remember. But to end on a nice note, this was sent to me in the mail by our wonderful Steve, Charlton 66. I'll start with the back cover. It's a treasury.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and this is just absolutely beautiful. Look at the Hulk there.
Wait, Micah, that's Gil Kane.
What?
How do you like that?
It can't be. That's good stuff.
Gil Kane.
GK. What is that? GK there.
I had a bad feeling about all this. This,
you know, I never thought of Michael Jackson and Ted Nugent together. That's like the ultimate like hodgepodge there. Great stuff.
Well, all kidding aside, thank you so much, Steve.
You're welcome.
It really is great. My pleasure. I think I have all the treasuries now I really want. I'm only missing the Hulk versus Batman. But there's one or two Disneys I don't.
Do you have the Wizard of Oz?
No, that's another one.
But, yeah, I'd like to get that one. I think it's John Buscema did the artwork in that one. I'd like to get that one.
Well, there you go, Maranya. Even I started off. So, now you've seen everything.
That's a first, right?
Yeah, probably the last. we'll go to Gratu and see what he's up to.
Here's a Twilight Zone I got in November of 73. Oh, wow.
Excellent.
Wow, that's a nice one.
Beginning of my third, cover, yeah. Middle of my third grade year. And I
was wow.
Twilight Zone and some of the other shows that Gold Key, Dark Shadows also. I never was, I was exposed to them through the comics before I ever saw them, because I didn't see Twilight Zone until I was in fifth grade living in near Seattle, Washington. It just wasn't ever syndicated anywhere else. There's another, let's see. This is March of 75.
Oh, yeah.
I wish I had some other issues. This one, I'm thinking, must be. Is this a reprint of an earlier issue? Because suddenly, in the 30 cent era, that just looks like a cover that's too good.
That is a good cover.
Because, you know, the issue before it, like one of the issues before it, was pretty lackluster, I think. And then there's one of these that's like one of the worst covers I've ever seen on. It looks like van art. really, that looks like
my artwork
that, you know, prison art. Really, it looks like it was sent from prison.
Picasso.
Yeah.
Some great covers. I wish I had a bigger collection of Twilight Zone.
Bigger than mine. I don't even have one issue. I don't even know where it's at. Oh,
well,
that's awesome!
Like Salvador Dali.
I remember is they were on this planet and they were the sun was gonna burn out, and then at the end you find out they're actually orbiting around a light bulb in someone's living room. And I thought, well, that's kind of a cool, not exactly worthy of Rod Serling, but that's kind of hard to do to get, because he was so great. And along the same vein, here's Stevie's girlfriend Maisie.
Me and her, we go way back. Like the artwork.
Yeah, Stevie. Exactly.
What is it? Oh,
Steve.
I said me and her, we go way back.
Oh, yeah, right. Well, I always thought she looked like Kaylee McEnany, but then. Well, let's see what else we got in here. Here's a nice cover.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Yeah,
look at that. That's a good one. That's a real good one.
What's the title? What's the title of that?
Picture Parade.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was covering it up. It's Picture Parade.
Cool.
Yeah.
That's atomic cover.
Yeah. It's,
it's so crazy. Yeah. He's there loving on his dog, and there's an atomic explosion in the background.
Yeah.
Wow,
it's really hard to get the light just right because of this.
That's a nice one, but, yeah.
Some of these covers you would think, gosh, that must have been done by Dave Stevens, except he wasn't born or was maybe about to be born, because you can really tell where his style came from studying these.
Yeah, looks like a Maurice Whitman. Yeah, it's beautiful.
There was a time, I think, in the mid-80s, I thought, well, I'll start collecting fiction house. And I bought a few at a convention at the Dallas Fantasy Fair. And then I realized that I can't afford to collect fiction house. I wish I could, but I bought like four or five. And then I just thought, oh, well, I'll leave this to the people that have lots of money. Here's a beat up on a fear.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. Still cool.
Very cool.
I think this came just in a brick of comics. They used to take damaged comics, seal them up at Lone Star Comics and sell them for $10. And that was just happened to be in there, I'm pretty sure.
Wow, what a deal.
I do not remember actually buying that. It was just sometimes there'd be something like that in there. Okay. There's a...
beautiful. Yeah.
Something.
I wish this guy was our president right now. I really think he'll do a better job. Not to be political or anything. Okay. There's got to be something entertaining here. Your Spaceman.
Ah, that's a great title. That's cool. Yeah.
I think that's pretty good. Cool.
Really.
That's awesome.
Well, I don't know. I'll look around for some more stuff.
Okay.
Pretty cool.
Super duper. That's great. Duper, all right, let's, I have all the catchphrases the kids use these days. Like totally
all. Know, that thing, Madhouse, my head, you know, yeah. It's like, it's a mad pad dad you've got here. You know, it's you know, now that the current thing is to add, like, stop, I don't want to go there. It's like, it's a, yeah, you know, we got to do that one night just to make ourselves feel younger. Just every sentence we say.
Yeah, you see that when they used to say bro, now they say bra.
Yeah, like it's bra.
Like it's a woman's clothing thing, bra. Yeah.
Yeah, bro. Yeah, we ought to just like write all of these things down and just use them one night. It would be really fun.
Oh, yeah. It'd be hilarious. Meyer, are you able to go?
Yes, I am. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can. We can, bro. Oh, yeah. Go ahead, bro.
What's up, bro? Those comic books were totally radical.
Cool.
They were fire. They were fire.
All right. So I went looking for Twilight Zone comics myself, but I found Tweety and Sylvester instead. looking because it was all alphabetical. So there were Twilight Zones there, but they're by this Now Comics.
Cool.
Are they good? I have the Now Green Hornet. I've never read it.
Yeah. I don't mind them. They're okay. Yeah. I read these when I bought them. I haven't reread them since. These are quarter bin comics. You used to be able to find these for 25 cents or 50 cents.
Well, worth it, too.
But then also, because we're in the teas, I found these. Now, these are really good. Remember these Twisted Tales?
Yeah, that is good.
Very good, yeah.
She needs to close her window.
I love this cover. This cover's great, right? Can you see that okay?
Yeah.
Yeah. Add to his collection.
We have Bruce Jones.
Here's another Corbin.
Well, that last one was Wrightson, I believe, right?
Yeah, it was. So it was Corbin, Wrightson, Corbin. That's the first three issues. How about that? Wasn't this great?
Yeah.
Those were really close to EC.
Yeah.
Rania's right. Bra really is a Jamaican deal. They've been saying that for 50, 60 years.
Oh. Okay.
But,
you know. I'm probably misculturing something.
But no, it started a couple of years ago in American culture. I don't know how.
No, well, no.
I'm going to bring you with Michael Jackson because little Michael there. And, you know, now we're into the R's, and this just happened to be in the stack, totally by coincidence.
Could that be a Gulliver's Travel type
situation? It is.
Okay.
It's a Gulliver's Travel reference. He's on propanolol or something like that.
He's on something.
Yeah.
Weird.
I've never seen that one before.
You know, these are kind of cool. Have you guys ever seen or heard of Rockin' Bones before?
Yeah.
So this is kind of good. I forget this guy's name. This is kind of the baby of this one artist and writer who was doing this thing, right? This homage to the stuff we like back in the 90s. It's pretty good. I like Rockin' Bones.
Rockin' Bones. I'm gonna write that down.
Yeah, the guy that popularized that song before the Cramps was Ronnie Dawson. He's passed away. He was a friend of mine. He was out of Dallas, rockabilly guy out of Dallas.
These are really fun, really good reads. It's kind of like an underground parody of the stuff we like. That's how I would describe it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Has a little flavor to it too.
This is, remember this? So this was probably the first time I saw Dave Stevens. I bought this off the stands at kind of at the beginning of finding out about him.
Okay.
Other than like those covers that he did with the, was that same company that Pacific Comics, those Alien World.
Yeah. Yeah.
First I saw it was Alien World. And then let's just finish up with some ROM.
Nice.
Yeah, we're talking earlier, or maybe a few days ago, about people like unusual comic book collectors. You know, people that they're not actual comic collectors; they just collect one comic, right? Certain they're like kids or young adults that read one comic book or something excites them. Like I knew this girl that only owned and only read Doctor Strange comics and had no interest in any other type of comics. So I was thinking ROM could be like that, and then I got to thinking how. When ROM first came out, I bought two issues because I was speculating and I was 12 years old. So I bought
original specker.
9.8s or 9.6s because I only read one of them once. So then I got to thinking about, you know, I'm always trying to pare down the collection. Then I got to thinking about these eccentricities, certain people that are eccentric in certain ways. Like there might be that person who just, not only does he only collect ROM comics, he only collects ROM number one. So I was thinking about selling all 800 books or 8,000 books I have and just replacing them all with ROM number one.
Huh. I think that's like a $100 book now, but I could be wrong.
Am I right?
Meyer, that's a good idea.
yeah. There's an antique store in Fort Worth. The entire wall is covered with just that Herb Albert cover. With the entire wall.
That is awesome. See, that's, I think it's funny. I think it's kind of, you know, it reminds me of what was that that book that Tom Hanks made of, was in the movie about finding the tracing the history of Jesus or something? The Da Vinci Code. Do you remember that Da Vinci Code book, the paperback? At one time, it was like any Goodwill that you went to, there would be 50 copies of Da Vinci Code. Oh, so at one point here in San Francisco, maybe 10 or 15 years ago, somebody made an art installation in Golden Gate Park that were park benches that were made only of copies of the Da Vinci Code, like glued together and shellacked into the shape of a bench. And then another one was just VHS tapes of Titanic, double tapes of Titanic, all like glued and varnished to make a big piece of furniture. It was cool. I thought it was a cool idea.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, sir. How about the good captain now?
Yeah. Well, I've been going through my collection, you know, everything what I got down here, trying to organize it. And I've been coming across a lot of stuff that I just didn't know I had.
I like your shirt, Captain.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, very cool.
Yeah. Oh,
the Facebook. No Mink.
Facebook group.
Yeah. Oh, Jason Mink. Yep.
Yeah, Jason Mink.
Yeah, he's good. I like that. I like Jason. What the hell now? Oh, I found some of these here. That are, I had, I think this wasn't 2014, I can't remember, but they're signed by Alex Ross when Dynamite was putting these out. Black.
Oh, Black. Those are great.
Yeah.
Alex Ross, that's Zero.
Yeah.
I did kind of like that they were bringing back the Golden Age heroes and
stuff. Yeah, just superpowers.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Green Llama and the Black Terror.
Yeah. He's such a great artist, you know. If he just done all the interiors, those would be...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it'd be fantastic.
Yeah, he's more like... when you look at his art, though, it's more like they're all like paintings.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I don't... know how good it is, you know, to illustrate for comic book panels.
Look at Jackson's comment.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, I'm here to inspire. I'm here to help. I want to help people manage their collection.
Hans, Alex Ross did do that Fantastic Four hardcover last year, to give you an idea of how he does with sequential art.
Let's see what I got here.
Probably the first one he's done since Kingdom Come.
Right.
Maybe I should do that with all the 234s of Batman and Robin.
It's a great cover.
Yeah, I showed this one in the last Fossil show, I think, but then I found another one. I didn't know, and this is signed by Neil Adams.
All right.
And what did I write anything in here? It had to be at the Graham Crackers. What's on that? And then I think I showed this. It's kind of the reader copy that I had. And then as I'm going through everything, I found. Or did I show this one? I don't know. I have another copy. This is the first appearance of the Lazarus Pit. And then I found this one that's signed by him, Neil Adams.
Wow.
So maybe I should just sell all of those too. Yeah, I showed this, I think, the last time, Neil Adams' signature on this.
Sweet.
That's from Detective Comics.
31, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
The beauty, yeah.
And then I found these. In a box with all some modern books. This is the first appearance of Gwen, Spider-Gwen. This is the second printing. These things are going up in price. This is from 2014. So I don't know. I think I might. I was talking to Mark, who has the comic shop. He said I should get this stuff graded and sold. You know, I got the first printing. There's some guys asking $1,500 for this on eBay.
You're kidding.
Yeah.
$1,500, man. It's another one.
So you could turn that into a really cool old comic.
I've got another one. That's probably, I think I'm going to have the shop send these all in to be graded and sold, because I don't really even like the character that much, you know, Spider-Gwen. But
wow.
Let's see what else I got. Oh, there's let me do this. Yeah, this was in 2014. See, I kept that from Graham Crackers when I met Neil Adams, and he signed it. At first, he says, well, I can't sign that. That's not my art, you know? And I said, yeah, I know it's not your art on the cover, but you did some interior artwork. And he says to me, no, I didn't. I says, yeah, you did a couple panels. He says, no, I didn't. I says, yeah, you did. And the guys behind me, there's a line, you know, they're all laughing and stuff. And then he goes, show me what you're talking about. So I showed him. There's this one panel, I can't remember where it was. And he's looking at it. And then a smile starts to come to him slowly, you know, but then he starts going, yeah, you're right. That is my artwork. That is me. He didn't even know it. He did so much stuff, you know. He didn't.
Then you smacked him around for being disagreeable, right?
And then at some other point, you know, I was getting some the posters he had, you know, signed and stuff. And then he was saying, well, it's going to be $35 at the convention. And I'm saying, $35, I'm talking to somebody. And he goes, are you bitching?
See, you needed to smack him.
Yeah, he's a character. He was a character, you know. What's the House of Secrets, 65.
That's a great one.
They got some great ads in here. Really great ads. I wrote it on the back here. They got the missile attack toy ad, public service ad, and then Aurora Monsters. Let me see if I can't. I always love the Aurora Monster ads.
I like those because I like the Eclipso story. I like those.
So that's pretty neat. Then let's see what else I got. A House of Secrets number 823. I think is this the first Mark Merlin? I believe it is. I didn't write nothing in the back. So.
Looks nice.
It's not bad. Not bad. And the. Out to Secrets with Crypto number 80. Prince Ramon.
Oh, yeah.
Like Ramon noodles. Ramon soup. You ever buy that in the grocery store? Chinese soup. We're called Ramon or Raymond. Maybe it's called Raymond. I don't know. Oh, here's the first appearance of Ramon.
Mark Merlin was in 23, Captain.
In 23?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's this one.
That's yeah, 23. You're right. Yeah, you're right.
And the first one, man, I just showed this.
Yeah, that's great.
Rod would love that one.
Yeah, I got these a long time ago. You know, you can't even buy anything on eBay anymore because they're just too outrageous with the prices.
Yeah.
And then you got the shipping and the taxes. And I just stick to the conventions. Now, once in a while, I might find something on eBay.
I was looking at an auction the other day, and some guy wanted $30 for shipping.
$30?
$30, yeah. It wasn't from overseas or anything. He was still wanting $30.
Wow.
I was like, no thanks, man.
Yeah. In most of the states now, they tax the shipping because they think that's part of the price now. And in Illinois, they do that.
Yeah.
So it's nuts. And I think this was, if I remember this right, maybe somebody knows, but I think this was in Seduction of the Innocent. I think because of the head, you know, boiling in the pot, or it might be because of this old witch. Well, I don't know. Maybe it's not even. Yeah, this old witch, you know, she has part of her thing there hanging out. Her left breast. I don't know. But it's a cool cover. I love this cover. And House of Secrets. What is it? 870? Sorry.
I love that one. Great stuff. I don't like that one.
That's cool.
Yeah, very cool.
That's what I got here. Adventure Comics 430. Black Orc.
Oh, yeah.
Third appearance, I think. Yeah, third appearance. And then 429. I paid $14 for this. Scripts in here are by Sheldon Meyer, by the way.
Yeah, those had good covers.
And then I got the first appearance, 428.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, I found two more in there. And I got three copies of that. Man. So.
See, I told you that Jackson was a Weisenheimer.
Yeah.
He is a Weisenheimer.
He is a Weisenheimer. What the hell? I can't read this with the cover. Cover's so dark you can't read the numbering. But it's House of Secrets 73.
Look at that. That is awesome. I've never seen that issue.
That's a good cover.
That is great.
Look at the strip, though. Oh, I'm glad I found these because I got to get them out of these bad backer boards. Man, look at that. It's not even really a real backer board.
That's a great cover.
Is this... I don't think this is a noteworthy issue, except the cover is just beautiful.
No, it was cut clips on, and it's great.
Well, that's all I got for right now. Unless you want to... I don't want to set off the green alarm again, but here, I'll just show you. Look at this. This is a Gil Kane cover. Mm-hmm. Undersea Agent.
Oh, wow.
I didn't know he went to Charlton.
No, this is a
Tower
record.
The Thunder Agent.
Oh, Tower. Thunder Agent.
Two companies couldn't contain that much greatness.
And Guerrero did this. This is a great cover. I love this cover.
Hmm.
Eli Kane. And then just one more thing. I don't know if I showed this before. I don't think I did, but maybe I did. Island of Dr. Moreau.
Ah.
Oh, yeah. It becomes great.
Another Eli Katz. Oh, Gil Kane. That was for Eric there. Okay, that's it right now. Thank you.
Okay. And speaking of Eric, good stuff, Captain. Let's wake him up and see if he's doing okay.
You know, I was just thinking about...
He's got that grin again.
How cool would it have been if Gil Kane had done romance comics? It beggars description, as they say. All right, we'll get this out of the way.
Oh, man.
I don't even know who I'm breathing. I'm just phoning it in.
That's the only one I know. That's the one I need.
That was Jambo.
Start with the stuff that came out today. This was a free Dawn of DC primer. And I got to admit, I'm actually starting to become a fan of this Dawn of DC.
Really?
What is Dawn of DC?
It's just the latest edition. There's right now about half the writers there really care, and the other half of them are writing to please Twitter. Here's Flash 799. Really fun series. Jeremy Adams. If everybody wrote like him, we'd all be buying 50 new comics a month.
Yeah.
Cool.
Here is Superman number 4.
The Kryptonite Claw. That's pretty neat. You got that 70s vibe to it there.
So, speaking of, World's Finest 15.
Oh. Okay.
Here's something that I found the first issue and completely forgot about it, and then the second issue came out today. This girl's kind of like a train wreck who actually killed somebody with her powers when she was a little kid, and now she's an adult hero. She drinks too much. She's involved with a senator, and the government wants her to go kill terrorists. And it's kind of set in like time jumping back late 80s into September 11th, 2001. And that'll tell you what sets up for issue 3. Here's the facsimile of Avengers 1 that came out today. New issue of Shudder.
Wow, great cover.
That's really neat.
And it's not as cool as the actual book, but here's the rest of us that don't have subscriptions to this got our back issue of Neil Adams today.
I like the Neil Adams.
That and Alter Ego both did really nice tributes.
They did. Alter Ego was really good.
There's some random 80s and a few 90s indie stuff I've been reading lately. There's American Flag, number 4. Number 5.
Oh, yeah.
Good stuff. You better cover this up, you trollop. Blue Ribbon Comics number 1, which reprints the first issue of The Fly.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's a DN Agents number 9. Mm. Love this series.
Yes.
The obligatory EC reprint.
Very cool.
Yes.
And I think I heard Jambo snoring there, so let's wake him up.
Yeah. Yes. Fin Force. What number is that?
A 119.
Right.
When the prices went up and the color disappeared. But they're still hanging in, even though apparently issue 200 got pushed back again. So one issue, Ghost Shadow. This is kind of interesting. It was set in the present, but the Shadow had been in cryogenic sleep for about a half a century, and one of his aide-de-camps woke him up, and he was about 90 now.
I love that character, the Ghost.
The early iterations, because once the SJWs got a hold of her, she got the Taliban approved costume and became all about, men suck even more than the original premise. There's a Grim Jack number 4.
Very cool.
That's nice.
Number 5.
Oh yeah.
Now, I said my high school friend Todd was in chat earlier, and we're in a little group with another guy named George. And if he's here, he may not have a YouTube subscription, so he may not be able to comment. But this was one of his favorite series, and he got me started on it. It's number 7.
That is Scout. Scout was another good one.
Yeah, and unfortunately, thanks to Scout, I liked Grimjack when Flynn Henry was doing the art, but it was never the same.
Right.
Here's Pacific Presents number 1. Dave Stevens gets 12 pages, but Steve Ditko got, 16 or 18 to tell his story. No offense to Steve, but I'd rather have more Dave.
Yeah.
Here's first issue of Scorpio Rose.
Oh, yeah. My comic buying back in the day, man. It's good stuff.
Nexus number 8. Proving that 26 letters are too many for me to keep alphabetized. number 9. Nice little reprint series. Seduction of the Innocent.
Yeah.
Number 1. Here's number 2 of 3.
Oh, nice.
Love that art.
3 of 3. And an idea they must have gotten from the original Punisher miniseries. Here's issue 4 of the 3-issue series, which actually went 6. Speaking of a series that's pretty much forgotten, but absolutely loved it, Trouble with Girls.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. All he wanted was a nice book and quiet day to read it. Number 7 from the next series. Number 8. And we'll close this round with Twisted Tales number 9.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wait a minute. I think Jamie's nodding off again. Gotta keep everybody awake. All right, that's it for this round.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, Eric. I've just heard from Spinner Rack. He's still stuck at work, but he hopes to catch a train and join us if we're still going. But in the meantime, I will show some Forbidden Worlds. These are the superhero ones and robot dogs.
Wow. I'm sunk.
Wow.
That's what all the kids say these days. I'm sunk.
Ooh,
yeah. A crazy thing.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm.
I put all that's the superhero ones.
That's nice.
The Magic Man.
Here he's coming to rescue Harold Lloyd. Seeing how many fossils got that.
Yes.
I think that bomb is atomic, but I can't be sure.
It looks like it.
Uh-oh. Bondage cover.
Yeah, Mr. Mystery number six.
This used to be at Six Flags, but...
There were some safety concerns, and they took it out.
People are always whining.
I know.
Now, if I could, if they ever tapped me to play a superhero, I could probably pull this one off.
Kind of looks like Curly from the Three Stooges.
I like his lederhosen.
Yes, I have red hair.
Compliments of Magic Man. Look at him melting that tank. That's pretty cool. Nice.
Wow.
Got Magic Man. Ho, ho, ho. Green Giant. Oh, cool.
Reptile. Really, that's a good cover. Oh, look at that bug. Was that a tick? A flea?
The swarm.
Huh.
To the hive.
How about a ghost?
Oh, yeah.
Why not? A great one.
They're always good.
Wow. Is that Cardi? It's like Nick Cardi.
I don't know. And if you can't get the body to the coffin,
the coffin to you.
Yeah. And while he's checking that out, there's a giant hand. Yes. This will make Eric happy. He doesn't like those kids.
Who does?
This is a creepy one. It's a weird Western. Kids.
Oh, wow. Ghost of Jonah Hex.
Huh.
That's a cool one. Yeah, that's a must-buy right there.
That horse looks scary.
Yes.
Hmm.
I'd be more afraid of the horse than what's riding on him.
Now, Friday, I'm going to be releasing a video. It's not a stream, but some of you saw my video with Joe Morton where I went to his house.
Yeah. Well,
yesterday he came over here and had dinner with me and the wife, and he came bearing gifts.
Oh, nice.
I saw my Boris Karloff video because I was able to get it onto a DVD thanks to Gratu's help. And he thought I could handle this. He gave me this little mystery digest of Boris Karloff.
Oh, wow.
Cool.
Nice.
And of course, you know, it's seen better days, but I didn't have these. These digests, I think there's about 15 of them, and my screen went black. I don't know if you guys can still hear me.
Yeah, but, yeah.
Three of them were Boris Karloff. The others were like Ripley's Believe It or Not or Grimm's Ghost Story, something like that. But very, very cool, and I was so happy to get it. So you're saying, what was he doing over here? Well, we made a little video, and it'll be on Friday. Here's a little sample of it. He brought some pulps from the 1920s, 1926,
27,
28,
yeah. 29. Wow, so, look at that one. And that's got to be expensive.
So I've make sure I get all whittled down to about 34 minutes, something like that. So Cool. Be on the lookout for that Friday. So
definitely.
That was it. That was it for my round. I guess we could go to Steve if you would like.
Yep. All right. A little bit of Wrightson in our life. We've got a little bit of Grim Mystery Tales. Everyone got a copy of this
one. Oh, yeah. It's a good cover, man. Yeah, such a good cover.
It is such a great one. Of course, Captain America 117.
Nice.
I read this. Very I read nice. This afternoon. Thank you. Number 57, The Brave and the Bold. Metamorpho.
Those are great Silver Age books.
Yeah. Number 58. And look at that cover, man. How can anyone not buy this book? I beyond back in the day. Mm. Army of War 150.
Wow.
Metamorpho 1, which this is just a stunning cover.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Love it.
Yeah, there's a lot going on there. It's just.
It does. It does. Project Fury, Atomic Commandos, number 62. Basic Training of Nick Fury.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then Basic. Strange Tales, 169.
Oh, yeah.
Brother Voodoo. That's the first Brother Voodoo, right?
Yes, it is. Yep. I was probably in my reading box.
Wow.
Well, I think I've showed this before. But
you've got the heavy hitters tonight.
Yeah, right. It's got a little spine issue up there. But
that's Adams' cover, right? Neil Adams did that cover.
It is. Yeah, absolutely.
He told Hans that it wasn't.
Oh man. Adventure Comics 431.
Beautiful cover.
Thank you. And we gotta bring some Ditko in the action. We got Mr. Ray, number four. What is this issue? I don't know what issue number issue this is.
Mr. A.
I don't think. Hmm. But these are kind of scarce around these parts. I get them when I can. I only got like four different issues, plus the stuff that he released with Robin Snyder. That stuff.
I got a lot of that.
Yogi Bear, number two.
Right.
Yeah, that was a pretty good book. I read that today. I know I showed this before, but Lobo.
Oh yeah.
Number one. Reading pile.
Hmm.
And Adventure of the Fear, number 10.
Yeah.
There we go.
Great.
And I've showed this before, I was rereading it again. So again, it was in the reading pile. Captain Video.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I hear you, old Captain Video. Awesome.
Captain Video.
Remember that Jackie Gleason episode, Honeymooners?
Yep.
Yeah.
Last but not least, Blue Circle, number 3.
Oh, yeah, look at that. Got an Adolf cover.
That's an expensive book. Yeah.
It is. It's becoming very expensive now. I seen a copy in this grade for $1,500, and that's what they were asking for it. I don't know if that's what they're going to get for it.
Well, yeah.
That's astronomical.
I mean, that's in nice shape, and yeah, they're sought after because of the Hitler covers.
Yeah,
I'd rather pay $1,500 for that than $1,500 for this.
Oh yeah, yeah. I hear you. And last thing before I go, I found this, the Illustrated History of Crime.
Yeah,
Mike Benton. It's pretty well illustrated. It was a library book, I think. Well, there's no library thing in it, but it's got the Mylar jacket on it. But there's a series of books. I didn't know. You can't see it because of the price tag. But illustrated history of horror, superhero, science fiction, and superhero.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. All in this series. This is number 5, they say, in this series. So it's pretty good. It's got a lot of good information, a lot of good illustrations in it.
When I did the comic book memory show, I showed all 6 of those. They're phenomenal. So they're well worth seeking out.
You have them all?
Yes.
Wow. Excellent. Excellent. This was funny. I had this. My bookshelf has these lips that these edges that tuck in. And that was tucked in between that. And I forgot that I'd even had it. And it was a thicker book hiding it. When I pulled it out to read a thicker book, I saw that, and I was just like, wow, I did not know I had this. So, I'm looking forward to finding the rest of them. That's going to be a hunt to get the rest of those books. That's all I got, guys. Thank you.
All right.
Great stuff, Steve.
Okay. Very good. All right. And we are joined by Spinner Rack. Hello, sir.
Hey, Dave.
All right. Hello, everybody. Hey, Dave.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Because you're getting home late, you probably haven't had supper. You want us to go right to you, Dave? So,
No. Yeah, if you want, but no hurry. So,
okay.
No hurry. But I know I have to eat pretty late. So, whatever you want to do.
Okay. All right, Gratu, you're ready.
Well, you heard about Biden hiring 30,000 new IRS agents that are going to be armed, but this is the life they'll actually lead. This comic, this Green Panda, but he's a tax guy. He's seeking. I mean, that's what this comic is about. But for some reason, he goes to other countries and has to deal with Mussolini coming back. So this is the excitement you can have if you put in your application to be one of these new IRS agents. You can be a T-man.
Weisenheimer.
Show this to a young person today with the coloring of the Asian people. They flip out. I can't believe this 20-year-old girl with pronouns saw Master of Kung Fu comic where he's just colored straight yellow. You know, she was all excited about the movie coming out. It's like, I can't believe this. It's like how they colored in comics because they didn't have that many color options. But yeah, I guess
it's a Hitler cover.
I guess so. So there's all kinds of ways you can seek IRS unpaid taxes, I guess.
That's a pretty cool little series. You gotta take
these
books out
because these bags.
Yeah, look that up.
Anyway, I got a bunch of these at some point because I think I got them at Lone Star Comics. They just somehow, I guess, bought a collection of them. So,
yeah, you never showed those before, did you?
I think I've shown a few of them. But I've shown everything that's in this box about 3 times.
Really?
I'm recycling. It's like
I never seen them.
Yeah, I just
that's terrific.
I do a lot of recycling because I don't get a lot of new stuff.
Well, I never saw them.
This Toy Town was a gift from Night Tiger.
Oh,
he just sent a whole bunch of comics to me about 6 months, 7 months ago.
That looks interesting.
Yeah. What else? It's Davy Crockett, Indian fighter.
Great TV series.
Yeah.
All that I miss all that stuff.
Yeah. Okay. What else? Let me show real quick. pull out a hunk of comics at random. These, the Space Mouse comic I was seeking for many years, because in the family album I see, before I was born, one of my older brothers holding this comic. And so I always wanted that comic that he had. So here's actually the case where I have two of them.
It could have been
this one.
Gratu, since you have two of those copies where he's sitting on the satellite, whenever you get that Daffy from Gotham where he's trying to hit Sputnik with a tennis racket, you might put those two together on the wall or something.
Oh, yeah. Hold on a second. That's a good idea. That may actually... the heck would that be?
I don't know. You got that yet?
Or... here. That might actually be here.
Since you have two of them, you can always keep one filed away properly and put one up on the wall.
Absolutely. Maybe there's, I wonder how many comic book covers show Sputnik. Maybe you could fill a whole wall with it and be completely insane. Let's see. That would be great, actually. That's a great idea. I didn't even think of that. So, and then this is the earliest Star Trek I have.
Yeah.
That's one of my favorite covers of it. Yeah, it's got the whole crew.
And that's got to be my favorite logo for Star Trek. That should just be the official logo.
Cut through the name.
And, this almost looks like something they would have done on the old show. Something like this.
Yeah.
Anyway, I guess, here's a mummy cover. I got to show a mummy cover and then I'll let other people go.
Oh, cool. Oh,
nice. Yeah. That's a good one.
They're just indiscriminately shooting the mummies.
Yeah. Spock with
a red shirt. So he's in danger. They were using black and white reference photos, obviously, and had no idea what color to color the shirts.
Forget the prime directive, just start killing everybody.
All right. You ready now, Spinner?
Sure.
Now let me get up a proper welcome. Michael Taylor's welcome. Yeah, there we go.
All right.
All right, Dr. Solar. Dr. Solar, this is issue number one.
All right.
Nice. And the artist on this cover, and I printed some information off, so I'll tell you real quickly. Richard Gorman, Powers was his name, and he was introduced to art when his uncle gave him a sketchbook and went to several art schools. And when he got married, he became a career illustrator for magazines and publishing houses. And he eventually became one of the most influential science and fantasy fiction artists of all time. But the interesting thing was is that he started out kind of in a conventional pulp style, but evolved, and you're going to kind of see this in this cover, to a surrealist. He was influenced by the cubists like Picasso. And then it says he also started dabbling in abstract art and collage at a later age before dying in 1996 at the age of 75. And you can see kind of that abstract collage work, I think, in this cover.
Absolutely. And number two, just like that.
Number two, and then it was taken over by the workhorse George Wilson.
Hey Dave, on the label of that slab, do they give that artist credit? Because I fear Gold Key, they don't care.
No, they do. They say Richard Powers cover.
Good. Yeah. Okay.
And you know what's interesting about it to me is it came out in 62. You know, you think about what the comic book art back then, Marvel was just starting up with its Stan Lee gang, and to have this kind of art on a cover is pretty
It's more of a serious sci-fi approach, like from a paperback cover.
Yeah, I've always wanted to get that book, and I finally got it for a good price. All right, here's Avengers 43. Of course, this is the first appearance of the Red Guardian. Always nice. Love these colors on this cover. They really kind of pop. And I think
it's a nice copy.
Buscema cover, right? I think so.
Yeah.
Buscema or Heck, right?
Yeah, it might be Heck, yeah.
There we go.
Oh, look at that. Iron Mask. That's
cool. Yeah, this guy's interesting because I think I've actually showed a Golden Age version when he maybe first appeared and, you know, made comments that he was the original Iron Man. All right, here's a Avengers number 17, the Hulk appearance.
Oh, yeah. Minotaur.
Minotaur. Oh, yeah.
Here's hey, hey,
what happened to Reed Richards there?
Yeah, all right.
You're hunting.
You took the joke away from me. Yeah.
Sorry.
All right. Here's the Tales to a Suspense cover. This is 73 issue from 1966, cover date of January.
Wow. That's beautiful. Yeah.
8.0.
I always like this cover.
Very cool.
Some of these I will be cracking out of their slabs. I need to decide what.
You need to do that one night. All those fossils get together and bust open a bunch of graded books.
There's a hammer on it, man. A hammer and chisel.
This is one I have cracked out of a slab. And
oh, wow. All right.
So.
Good on you. You set it free.
Yeah. This issue always cracked me up. It's got, you know,
yeah, that's a good one.
The monster on the drive-in theater screen there, and then of course there he is coming around. The back.
Mm-hmm. Very cool.
That very cool.
And I'll do one more before my next round. This is Tales 146 from 1966.
Yeah.
Good stuff. Yeah, kind of that far out style.
Yeah.
So, all righty.
Okay. Cool. Thank you, Spinner. Let's see. Are we up for Jambo? Or?
Sure.
I think that's the order we were. Well,
like I said, I got some stuff from Kevin from Gotham City. He sent me this. I had the. Some of the Garbage Pail Kid cards on it and was signed by Smoking Joe.
Oh.
Check that babe out right there. Palm Trina. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Honolulu.
Honolulu, baby. Where'd you get those eyes?
So, I didn't do my homework, and I didn't get no Twilight Zone out, but I do have a nice Gray Morrow cover there.
Good grief.
Yeah.
Is that the...
Got a monster on his back.
I haven't seen that. Yeah.
So. Yeah, I was liking that.
What number is it?
That was number 11.
11.
Yes.
Very cool.
And one of these little Jimmy Steranko doing Marvel's version of Sheena.
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 Sheena. Great covers. Yeah. I always love those jungle covers. Good girl art, bad girl art.
And I got that one from him.
The Haunted Horseman.
Yeah, Frank Frazetta reprint. Yeah, it's Ghost Rider reprint.
Mm-hmm.
Dick Ayers art on the inside of it. Yeah.
Yep.
Good stuff. Got one of these. Wow. Kirby and Buscema. Can't go wrong.
Nope.
And kind of a roughed up copy of Strange 175. This very copy, nice. It's love gone up. Yeah, it's gone up a lot because of Cleo on the cover or something like that. Mm-hmm. So, and it's for you, Eric.
Mm-hmm.
Number 10.
Talk about skimpy.
And number 7.
I like it. They each want a piece of him. I wonder why.
Who knows why you're hiding under that fur?
Every cover's like a Nair commercial, right? Who has sugar shorts?
Mm-hmm.
That.
Oh, that's a good issue.
Juggernaut. But none of the heroes are helping him. That there was none of them in the book either. So, yeah. I don't know what the deal was. And check out the Juggernaut stash there. Look at that mustache.
Huh.
Right?
That's funny.
I agree, Maranya.
I agree with Maranya.
And last one for me. Kevin sent me that. It was pretty cool.
It's nice.
Yeah. So, always liked that cover, man. That was awesome. One of my favorites from the Golden Age.
Yeah.
One of these days, when my rich uncle gets out of the poorhouse, I'm going to buy that. Go ahead, guys.
All right. Are we up to the great captain here?
Oh, me again? I don't know. Yeah, I guess I did. Well, I was going to show some romance, but I think I'll show those next time. Like I said, I've been going through a lot of different boxes and trying to organize, and I'm coming up with a lot of the stuff that I got to rebag and board. I found all these big Dell books. Walt Disney Picnic Party. This is a Dell Giant, I think. Isn't that what they call them, Dell Giants?
Could be.
Yeah, that's great. So, yeah.
Number 7. This. Number, I can't even read this stuff. Number 3.
Oh, I love that cover.
This I probably showed before. Is this already in Mylar? So I must have.
It's wonderful.
1960. Number Stell Giant 39. There's another one that I must have shown before.
Oh, man, that's beautiful.
That's a good one, yeah.
Here's here's Bugs Bunny Halloween Parade number 1.
Great.
I have to find a proper size bag. I don't even think these can fit in the some of the Mylars that I got, unless it's a magazine size. This is like a silver golden bag, and it won't even fit in there.
Oh, wow.
Nah, it won't. It'll be too tight. Nah. Somebody's have seen better days, though. What's that, number 3?
Those are par for the course for a lot of those Dell Giants. People love them, you know? They read them like crazy.
It's hard to find these things with a good, you know, square bound.
Yeah, it is.
It's number four, Winter Fun.
Nice.
Oh, that's a nice one. Nice blue cover. Out of the snow.
And they're getting a little warm there. Yogi Bear, Del Giant, Winter Sports.
Oh, that's a freaking gym right there.
Yeah. I got to pick these. These are like all, I don't know. This one I know I showed before, and then I lost it down here in a whirl of stuff and found it again. Tales from the Tomb, number one.
Oh, yeah. Good.
I've never seen that before.
1962. No. Bugs Bunny Vacation Funnies. This was, looks like there was a sticker on there or something at the top. But from 1955? Could that be right? Yeah.
Yeah.
1955.
Yeah, that's right.
This one I really love. The Hanna-Barbera Bandwagon. This is a gold key.
Yeah. That's a pricey book now.
Oh, wow. Look at that logo.
What the?
That's a great logo. Yeah, that's a heavy cardboard cover, too, isn't it, Captain? Mm-hmm.
Cardstock.
Yeah, it's kind of a rare cover.
Yeah.
They're not, okay. Yeah. They're very hard to come by.
Well, you guys know I'm always after Augie Doggy number one, and that's got Augie Doggy in it. I always suspect that he's driving the price up on all those.
Isn't this the first appearance of Touche Turtle?
Could be.
Huh. I got to investigate that.
That's such a great book.
Popeye the Sailor. Oh, this is a great cover. I like this.
Wow, more of the gold key. Wow.
Yeah, that's cool.
Look at the sea hag. Is she on there? No, Alice Goon.
Alice Goon is out there.
No sea hag.
No, there isn't a sea hag on there.
They're out of sea and no sea hag. Wow.
Well, yeah, she is. She's in the water.
Oh, okay.
There. Oh, yeah, right there.
Is she? Oh, wow. There she is. Okay.
That's got all the great villains in it.
That's great.
1962. Turok, Son of Stone.
Nice.
Wow.
They don't make these books like this anymore. They get so politicized with all this stuff and put in their social agendas in a lot of these comics today, you know. That's why I don't collect the modern stuff no more. This, I think, has a little bit of moisture damage on it. But,
wow.
This is from 1952. Number three, 1952. The year I was born.
Mm-hmm.
What else do you got here? Oh, this is a nice one, too. This is thick, man.
Wow.
Woody the Woodpecker.
You can't do that now with the new math. You have to go sideways. It's all weird.
Yeah. Wow. I got a bunch of Tarzans here, but I don't want to take up too much time. I think you usually try to go around 2 hours, right?
It depends. You might want to save a lot of those Tarzans for next time because
I think I will.
We're going to do some jungle action.
Okay, I'll do that.
Yeah, I'm hoping Jambo will rise to the occasion.
I'm gonna go dig out something.
I'm gonna leave that line alone.
They all know. Who hasn't gone twice? Eric and Spinner. Meyer. Here we go, Meyer. It's in Eric's contract to go last.
I pulled down, I have not all of them like Eric has, but I have some of these Mike Benton Illustrated History hardbacks Steve had.
All right.
Number three. And here's number four.
Neat.
Oh, cool.
Okay.
You're on the table. Wow.
Black Terror. Wow.
And then the one that you had, here's number five.
All right. Very nice. Yeah, I need to find the rest of those.
Those look great.
Here's Rip Hunter getting the chair. These aliens are left.
All right.
Ripley's.
Yeah,
oh,
nice.
That's a great thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Got a lot of these. Here's another one. I love these weird abstract ones.
Wow. Looks like a night gallery painting.
Wow.
Yeah, they do. Some of them, you know, some of them really do look like night gallery paintings, Steve. Look, like here's another one. It's just really strange.
Yeah.
And then, you know, these comics, these are last resort comics for me. These are comics that I would buy like on vacation or something, like, you know, at my aunt's house, and I run to the store to get a Slurpee and there's nothing good. And this would be like the back, you know, this is what you would get. Mm-hmm. Kind of dry, you know, it's kind of dry reading for an 8-year-old. Not Marvel Comics, which is what I was into.
It didn't like the blue back. There
you go. There you go.
Yeah, you know, I never picked a lot of those up when I was a kid, but now I can't get enough of them.
Yeah.
Same here. Meyer, go back two books where the girl's running. Yeah, does that lady's face look familiar? The Twilight Zone logo for our thumbnail. I don't have it. I could pull it up.
Oh, that's you're right.
I think that's his face.
I think that's it.
Yeah.
Okay. She's running from the train. Why doesn't she just move to the right? And then she doesn't need to worry about the train.
Exactly. Okay. Cool. I'll look for that, and I'll put both of them together sometime. See.
You want to see what the number this is?
Oh, I can find it, but go ahead.
Yeah, it's April of 72.
All right. All right.
There's just lots more of these, you know, and it's, you can see it was almost like it could be any month that you went into 7-Eleven, and every Ripley's kind of looks similar, right? They kind of look a lot alike to me. This one's cool. It's got this giant bat, right? Here's something. I'm still on the R's, so let's look at something that nobody talks about. This is the great title, Roach Mill. It's actually kind of good.
Wow.
You guys ever heard of Roach Mill?
No.
No.
It was an early Dark Horse title here.
Yeah, it looks like the logo is entirely different, too.
Yeah, it was early Dark Horse stuff. It was actually pretty good. You know, that's all I got this week. I've got to go.
Good stuff, Meyer.
Okay.
All right, Meyer. Thanks, buddy.
Thanks for having me, guys. I'm going to take this early, Micah. I've got to take a call, but thanks for having me.
All right. Take care,
Meyer. See you, buddy. Take care.
All right. We'll go to Spinner real quick.
Okay. All right. This is, Challengers of the Unknown, number 10.
Ooh,
nice. Round cover.
There you go.
Wow.
Yeah.
There you go.
There's a giant hand.
One of the 80-page giants.
It's great.
The color.
I'd kind of like to try to put this series together. You know, maybe have a third of them at best.
Are they talking about the 80-page giants?
Yeah, the G series of the 80. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Great cover.
Beautiful.
Great thicko.
Ooh. Classic. Oh, yeah. There you go.
Not the worst books ever, but. Great to hear.
They're goofy, but they're endearing, you know.
Who's that? The artist on there, Tony Tallarico?
I think. Yes. Yes.
Rock's two favorite artist.
Like Race Bannon.
Here's another one.
Frankensteiner, Race Bannon.
This is by, I'm not sure who this artist is.
This kid has a future.
Some guy by the name of
Kane. Never heard of
him. Some guy by the name of Kane. Eli Katz.
Okay, this is probably one of the world's worst covers. This is Sunset Carson number one. This is supposed to be a photo cover.
Huh.
But it's probably taken with the world's worst camera and then the world's worst production.
Maybe they did some color touch on there. And then
that's what I think they did. I think you're right, Hans.
It is horrible, which is the reason why I got it. It's an oddity. They didn't do all of their covers that horrible. Here's issue number four, which is a little bit better.
Yeah, that's a nice one. I have that one. Good looking cover.
I think I've only got three of these, and here's the final one that I have.
Wow. Very nice.
Issue number two.
That's detail.
And then I'll end on two slabs. FF.
Very nice.
Good one.
I'll probably unslab this one. And then finally, number 66.
Okay, nice.
Yep.
Very cool.
It is nice. Son of a beehive.
Anyway. That's all I've got for today, Micah.
Okay. We're so glad you got to get here. Yeah, they're working you too hard down there. Okay, Eric, here's your moment.
First, let me say I look lovely on that cover. Micah will get that.
Yeah.
Might be the only one. But, I may have shown some of these before, but I'm trying to starting to clean up the couple years worth of messes, so I'm going to show these so I can get them out of the way. Some digests. Here's a Jughead and Archie, I think number 29. Some Laugh, 25. Number 20.
Amazing. They were everywhere.
Are they still making those? I think that they are.
They are making some. Here's the Archie Andrews, Where Are You?
They were everywhere, man.
Jughead Jones. Laugh number 19. So let's see. Archie Comics Digest 32. Wow. And shift gears to a Walt Disney Comics Digest from Gold Key.
Excellent.
Wow, Nick got a Zorro story in there.
Here's Archie's Superhero Comics Digest number 2.
Wonderful.
Not good.
And
didn't know they made those.
There's Adventure Comics 493. When DC inexplicably kept this series going, digest size. Mm-hmm. Here's 495. Let's see. 496. And you can shrink it down, but you can't stop the greatness, because there it is. It's on display. And in case you missed it the first time, have some more.
Bouncing Boy.
Cool. Bouncing Boy, too.
And even more.
That's awesome. The alien's head.
And then I don't know who did this one. Who cares?
Oh, that's cool. That's great. That's a great cover.
It is. Here's something called Shocking Tales Digest.
Oh, yeah. Man.
Who put that out? That's pretty...
This is
for a younger man's eyes. To...
we're all like that, man.
You're all reaper.
Yeah, well, let's see. Harvey.
That's wow. I gotta here's look for that. That's another one I got to look for now.
Some been working on trying to finish the best of DC Blue Ribbon Digest and the other one. There's Binky's Buddies. This is number 70.
That's a tough one, isn't it?
Yeah. Let's see. And then the special Blue Ribbon Digest. Here's number 7. There's
Sergeant Rock's Pride Battle Day.
Yeah, they're. I can't afford books older than me, Vangman. I mean, Comic Book Frog. Here's Strange Sports Stories, number 13. Here's number 63, Plop.
I never seen that one.
Yeah.
Let's see. Here's Best of 51, The Batman Family.
I didn't know they made that in the digest.
Here's Best of 49 Funny Stuff.
Goodness.
37 Funny Stuff.
Yeah, those are tough.
Now here's some that's kind of interesting. Best of Metal Men, it's number 34 if you could. But then here is the same book that looks like it has the Adventure Comics numbering because it's numbered 497.
Huh. Oh, I've never seen that.
Wow.
Interesting.
So very cool. I think I've finished DC Blue Ribbon, but I need one best of. There's like 71 of them. I think I need one, but I can't remember which one it is. Here's Katie Keene. Digest number 1.
Most books are younger than you.
Let's see. And then I think I've shown these before, but here's Diabolique number 1. Channel my Apollo here. And Diabolique number 2.
Wow.
So these were from Pacific Comics, the Pacific Comics.
I don't know. And then just to close out with something, a French Superman Batman.
Ooh, la la.
And that will do it.
Yeah. Ooh, la la, you touch my tra-la-la.
We all lapse into our Geeky Puppet Show characters when Venkman shows up. I mean, Comic Book Frog.
Yeah.
What happened to Grat 2?
He does not like the French.
Uh-oh.
Must not. I don't know. He might write in the chat here in a second. I don't know, but if he's still listening. Jambo is disappearing. That may be on my end. I don't know. There he is. Not okay.
Jambo.
Don't go into the light, Jambo.
All right. We were supposed to have Steve Caldwell, I Love Disney, on tonight, but he had some he had a lot of things going on, and he asked if he could show up next week, so we look forward to seeing him then. Just getting caught up. Okay. All right. Well,
if you can't come,
that's fine.
Hotel.
Maranya. Every now and then, one of the screens goes black. So maybe everybody's internet, but it could be mine. So.
And mine just did. Well, for a second.
Okay. Well, that's what happens when you go to the fossil zone. Everybody's computer goes screwy, so we probably better quit soon while we're still ahead.
So like dust I said, off I, the Jungle Books for next week, right?
Yes, Jungle or Human Torch. Jungle okay. with Human Torch. I know it'll make sense when you see the intro. So,
okay, gotcha.
I'll have a video coming out Friday. Don't forget to see Dr. Silver Age and Shannon on Saturday. Mm-hmm. And if any of you gentlemen, oh, by the way, I think it was just yesterday or today, Charlton put out a video. Make sure you stop by and see that.
Mm. Yeah.
And Spinner, you have any new ones coming out? Or?
You know, I might shoot one this weekend, and I'll show you the book it's going to be on. This book right here. And this book was graded a 9.0. I cracked it out of the slab, but we're going to talk about whether it should have been a 9.0 or not.
All right.
There are some issues inside. So I've never done a book like that or a video like that. So we'll see.
Cool.
I agree, Maranya. I agree. Okay.
Speaking of, just as a heads up, it won't be out for a little bit. We are dusting off the retrospectives at Thinking Critical, and we're going to be recording one for Spider-Man 33, the famous lifts the building off of him while he's trying to get Aunt May's medicine to her for, you know, her after her 19th nervous break or heart attack, 19th, I don't, whichever.
Aren't they killing her off in 26?
Oh, no, that's they're killing off Kamala Khan.
You think
for
so?
About a month. Oh yeah, they've already leaked it. But she's going to come back as a mutant because the movie's next like 2 months. But
we're talking about Spider-Man 26, right?
Yes.
Yeah. And, I thought they were going to bring back Gwen Stacy, and then there was some rumor that they're bringing her back, and that she was never really killed, and that the Green Goblin kept her contained or confined all these years, and he actually created a clone. And a Spider-Man killed a clone. So the real Gwen Stacy's coming back.
Sounds complicated.
Sure, why not?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Didn't they learn anything? You know, Spider-Man has been horrible since the initial clone saga.
Yeah.
In my opinion, at least.
It's definitely had more downs than ups.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
In this century. But
breaking up a little bit here.
And I just had my computer fixed. I guess this is probably as good as it's gonna get. I have about 2 hours of life, but actually I made it through 5 hours or like 4.5 hours of the auction Saturday. This is something about this connection. It starts to break down at the like about the 2 hour mark.
Jungle and Human Torch or Firestorm, basically Jungle or Fire. So it's a mixed bag, of course, and then the usual everything else like Jonah Hex I showed earlier. So
cool.
We always have a nice eclectic mix.
I just heard that. Oh, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Yeah, in the old days, we used to do a theme, but you know, now when we do a theme, it's just basically I'll get an idea for a little bitty thing, and we may mention it once or twice, but then it's back to the grab bag. So go ahead, Captain.
Oh, I heard that in the just yesterday. I heard about for the August solicits that Archie is introducing a transsexual character. Or they're making this guy, Danny Malloy. They're making him a transsexual, and he's supposed to have this love interest with Dilton Doiley. So that's coming out in August, and I think that everybody's going to be speculating on that or something. I don't know. It's just kind of strange. But, you know, he was gay to begin with. So I think that if I were gay, I'd be upset. Now they're turning a gay character into a transsexual. I mean, it's just everybody's getting on this bandwagon, yeah. I guess.
Pandering.
Yeah, pandering. But, you know, Why Not Art is back. Why Not Art is back on YouTube. He's got a channel. Video.
Good.
So I just want to announce that, you know, this is his channel. you want to. Why not? Yeah, this is it.
Is that Art 70
on YouTube? Why not Art 70?
Cool.
Who's that? So yeah, we were texting today, and he was telling me that he got his channel back, and I think they had to take it down or something because he was showing artwork, and his artwork, you know, had, you know, some nudity in it, but they said it was pornography, and there was no such thing as pornography anywhere in any of his artwork, you know. So it's just bizarre that they would take it down, and then they did the same thing I think on Instagram, or maybe they hacked into his account or something. I don't know, but. Anyway, he finally got it straightened out, you know. So he's got a new channel now.
I've tried to have him on before. He says Wednesdays are difficult, but
I'll talk with him. I'll get him to come on.
Well, I mean, we got Memorial Day coming up. If I'm not busy, I may stream something. Who knows? So, but no promises. I've got a lot of work to do. And on that note, we'll probably wrap up here in a second. Last call. Anybody else? Anything?
No. Nope. Right. I know I'm going to check out Rack and Bones, and I'm going to check out Shocking Tales.
On behalf of all the wonderful fossils that have joined me, the ones that are still here and the ones that left earlier, we wish you all a good night and happy drawing.
Good night, everybody in the chat. Thanks.
Bye, everybody. Thank you.
Very nice.